Okay, tell me about the podcast that you have where you guys rewatch Will and Grace.
Yeah.
What is it like watching yourself back 25 years ago?
My hair in season one was awful, so that part is really upsetting. Sean Hayes and I had lunch about a year ago, and he's got the huge podcast with Jason and Will, and he said, "What are we going to do?" And he pitched a rewatch, and I said, "That'd be great. I watch them all the time. It'd be fun." And he said, "I've never watched them." I said, "Wait a minute, what? You never watched our show when it was on? You didn't watch it?" He said, "No." So it's kind of a rewatch for me and a watch for him. And it's really fun to watch him respond to stuff he has no memory of, because he just didn't retain it in the same way I did. Whereas I'd watch it all the time. My son would come in and go, "Are you watching yourself on television? What is happening?" But it's week after week. We just did one this morning. It's just really fun to remember us as baby. I wasn't a baby. I was 35, but he looks like a baby in season one. He's so young, and his every instinct is just unchained.
Y'all look like y'all had so much fun doing it. Like, sometimes you could feel the energy from, like, the set through the TV.
Yeah.
And I feel like we got little bits in common because, like you said, I started out on American Idol, and Barry Manilow was a guest mentor on
Love
American Idol.
Barry.
And he was also a guest on y'all's show. Love me some Barry Manilow.
I met Barry because I was a huge fan. When I was a kid, I was like into Zeppelin and Barry Manilow. It was all the same. But I met him at the front row of the original Barbra Streisand farewell concert. She did hundreds more after that. And I introduced myself, and he said, "I'm a big fan." And I said, "You're a big fan? This is insane." So it was eventually, that's how I got him on the show. They wanted to write an episode around him. And he was so nervous. It was so weird.
He was nervous.
He was standing and he was looking at a crowd about this big. And he was like,
I
don't know how you do this every night. And I'm like, "You're Barry Manilow." It was something about the fact he had to say one line. He's playing himself.
He had one line.
And he had one line, and he was just like, this is nerve-wracking.
That is so funny.
Yeah.
And y'all did a song together.
Well, this is, I love to talk about this stuff because then you'll go and look it up. It was right near the end of the first run of the show, and NBC was putting out some sort of album of songs by people that had been on Will and Grace. And there was nothing original on it. It was just, and I said, can we do something? And the cast was like, we did. And I called up Barry and I said, maybe we can write a song together.
So y'all wrote a song.
Yeah, I had lyrics to something which I called Living with Grace, which is basically a love song from Will to Grace.
I sent
the lyrics to him. He wrote the song overnight and sent it back a demo, which I can no longer find, of him playing this melody he wrote and singing my words. And I remember at that moment, I'm listening to it in my dressing room, and Harry Connick Jr. walked past, and he looked over, he said, "What's that?" And I said, I think I just wrote a song with Barry Manilow.
Yeah.
And Harry went, "Sure you did."
Oh.
And walked up. But ended up, we recorded it at Capitol Records. I sing, Barry plays, Phil Ramone produced. We sold 37 copies. It was,
Listen, I didn't got to sing with him, but I didn't get to write a song with him. That is amazing.
It was pretty great. It was pretty good.
Okay, well.
You can look it up. It's on YouTube somewhere, Living with Grace.
All right, I will look it up. Thank you so much for being here. Will you come back to see us
again?
Thank
you.
If you like this video, smash that like button and subscribe to the Jennifer Hudson Show YouTube channel. Check your local listings or visit jenniferhudsonshow.com to see when you can watch 4 episodes in your area. And don't forget to sign up for the newsletter.